and welcome to The Watchman. We are here in Washington, D.C. for part one of a special two-part series from the nation's capital. Now, a major reason that we're here is to lay the groundwork and prepare for our upcoming CUFI Washington Summit. If you haven't signed up yet to join us here in Washington, D.C., visit CUFI.org, that's CUFI.org, to get all the details. But up first, as we've told you here on the show many times, anti-Semitism is rising. Look no further than a deadly shooting recently in a San Diego synagogue. Go back a little bit further than that. October 2018, the largest anti-Semitic attack in American history, where 11 people were slaughtered in Pittsburgh by a crazed anti-Semitic shooter. So we have the threat of physical violence, but the incitement. The New York Times, which many here consider the newspaper of record in the United States, recently published a disgusting anti-Semitic cartoon featuring Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Folks, you see it there on your screen. Prime Minister Netanyahu in the form of a dog with a Star of David dog collar around his neck, being led by a blind President Trump wearing a kippah or a yarmulke. This harkens back to cartoons from World War II, published in Nazi publications. Now, they've retracted it, they've apologized for it at least twice, but the damage is done. Sadly, anti-Semitism today is becoming mainstream. Not far from where I am standing right now here in Washington, D.C., on Capitol Hill, we now have new lawmakers, freshman lawmakers at the Capitol, who are espousing openly anti-Semitic views. I'm thinking of Rashida Tlaib from Michigan. I'm thinking of Ilhan Omar from Minnesota. Folks, these representatives working at the U.S. Capitol, elected members of Congress, are openly anti-Semitic, viciously anti-Israel.